Don't forget to wear a jacket or you're gonna catch a cold. Or will you? Hey friends, Laci Green here. Aye, 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 it's that time of year again. Everyone's getting sick, including me, sadly. Still getting over a little something, something. On Facebook, our DNews friend Christy Jimerson asked, could you guys do a video on why we get sick in the winter more than summer? I've done some research and there doesn't seem to be any definitive answers and I'm really curious now. Me too, Christy, me too. It's conventional wisdom that people tend to get sick more during the colder months. In fact, the word influenza comes from the aged Italian phrase influenza di freddo, or influence of the cold. But there's an odd conundrum here because scientists have found again and again that being in the cold doesn't actually make us sick or more prone to getting sick. So that part is just a myth. Even when we're shivering, our core body temperature stays the same. This is thanks to the magic of homeostasis. So if it's not the cold that's making us sick, what is it? The top explanation scientists have to offer is that when it's cold outside, people are crowded indoors. All throughout the year, at any given time, a few people around you are infected with some kind of contagious viruses or bacteria, even though they may not have any symptoms. But in the winter, we're in closer contact with them, which makes it infinitely easier for those bacteria and viruses to hop from person to person. We're also in closed air systems inside, so airborne particles just circulate through our homes, offices, and schools. Which brings me to my second perpetrator, schools, or more specifically, germy, sneezy, snot-nosed children. A huge study at the University of Warwick pinned children as the top spreaders of infection. This is because they have the highest number of daily social contacts. Children go back to school and then they're kept indoors with their germy peers right around the cold season. So they infect each other and then they infect their parents who infect their coworkers, and before you know it, the whole friggin' world is sick. A last contributing factor pertains to the flu specifically. Different microbes and viruses all survive and transmit at different temperatures, and for the flu, it transmits in the cold. At 41 degrees Fahrenheit, the flu virus is the most stable. It's ready to infect you and wreak havoc on your body and life, but as it becomes warmer, it's harder and harder for the virus to transmit. In fact, once the temperature hits 86 degrees, the flu virus can't be transmitted anymore. So there you go. The key to avoid getting sick this winter is to avoid all contact with other human beings. That's right, just stay in your basement this holiday season like the good little internet citizen that you are. Or maybe just head off to your own private tropical island. Thanks for joining me for DNews. Hope this helped answer your question, Christy. If you folks have any other video topics you'd like to see, let me know down below or on Twitter at DNews, and we'll check them out. Bye-bye.